Hello everyone, I hope everyone's having a good day. It is beautiful outside today. Let me take a look. It's nice. Yeah, we gotta enjoy this day because we don't get many of those. Lately it's been raining or cold or whatever, so now that we have a good day. But my daughter wakes up, she's over there. You can't see her, but she wakes up, we're about to go out and enjoy this day. Since mama's working again on the weekend, she's gonna have to spend her day with me. And I don't mind. Anyways, I'm going to jump right into this video. I'm going to share with you guys what happened to me about 2 days ago when I went to do my tax. And this might not be something you guys want to watch or hear, but I'm just going to share this with you guys. So, as you guys know, I am Christian. And I go every Sunday. I know I should go more often, but that's just when I go on Sundays. I'm going to try to get better at that. Going more often. And before I got baptized, going on Sundays, when the people come around with the basket for you to give money, it's not an obligation. You give money if you want to. A lot of people believe they don't need to give money, not just at our church, but anywhere. They don't believe in that. They think that's wrong, or they're just cheap, and they don't want to give money to the Lord because they think that the pastors are, the members are going to use that money for other things or for themselves, but that's not the case, man. I mean, bills got to get paid regardless. So, I mean, we use the light, we use everything in there, so I mean, somebody's got to take care of it, right? So, and, so anyways, I would always give like $1 or $2, $5 if that, if I got paid. Sometimes when I got paid, I had a lot of money left over, and I would never give a lot of money, like, good amount of money back. I would always give, like I said, like $1. I was also being cheap. But my mom always told me, she said, when you start working and you can help out, she's like, do it, trust me, God will bless you always, and you will never be in need of money. And she's a perfect example of this. My mom, I'm not gonna lie to you guys, I've called my mom before and been like, hey mom, can you help me out with like $20, $10? I'm broke right now. I don't get paid till next week. I mean, if you guys are ashamed of asking your parents or whatever, I know what's happened to you guys, but I'm not ashamed of it. I asked her because I know she's always going to be there for me, and she knows I got her back too. And she's a prime example of what I'm trying to get to. She doesn't work. She just takes care of kids, like my brother's kids, my baby, and maybe cousin's kids. And the little money that she gets from all of us, that's her paycheck. It ain't much, trust me. And it ain't an easy job taking care of other people's kids. It's stressful. I've seen her do it for many years. But one thing that I have never seen my mom been is broke. She's never been broke. Somehow, I make a lot more than she does on a paycheck. But I'm always broke, and she's never broke. I call her. I'm like, hey, mom, can I borrow $5? She comes home. She brings me 100 or 20. I'm like, dude, I don't need that much. I just need 5 or 10. She's like, no. I'm like, how do you have so much money if you don't even work? She's like, because I give to God whenever I have the chance. And I've always done it, and he always blesses me. She ain't lying, man. She always has money. And so that's why I try to do that also. But the very last time that I went to church, I've done this like 3 times, but I have given my last bit of money that I have in my wallet. And before I do it, though, I tell them, you know, this is all I have. You know I don't have more, but I believe that I'm doing the right thing and that you're going to bless me sooner or later. But I really wasn't expecting anything from him because he has blessed me already with too much. I already have my daughter. Everything that I have is because of God. So he really doesn't owe me anything, but I knew that he would take care of me at some point. And I totally forgot all about this, but it hit me yesterday when I went to do my taxes. Man, when the guy told me, you ready to see what you're going to get? I put my head down like this. I was like, man, because I'm used to getting $700, $900, which you guys know that ain't nothing. And when he told me the first time, he's like, this is what you're going to get before I do everything else that I have to add on there, like the house and the cars and all that other stuff that you get taxed for. He showed me the number. I was like, dang, like that. When he showed me that number took care exactly of the debt that I had I've been in this debt for about a year now, and every day that I wake up, I think about that money. I'm like, man, how am I gonna get that money together, knowing that I have a kid, that I have to take care of a home, and everything else. It would always stress me out. But when he showed me that, I was like, wow, that took care of that. And he's like, well, hold up, man, I'm not even done. We're just barely getting started. And I was like, okay. So whenever he got done, I got like a couple more grand than what he had shown me at first. I was like, wow, with one child and what I worked and what my wife, the little that my wife worked this year, we made that much. And I know I asked other people that had like 2-3 kids, and they made like a couple grand less than I did. I'm like, man, how's this possible? Then I came home and I was thinking. I'm like, I was really happy with the money that I got back. Like I said, I wasn't expecting this amount. And I was thinking, I'm like, why did I get so much? And I'm like, now I know why. Because whenever I gave the last bit of money that I had to God, so like I said before, he was going to take care of me at one point, and I guess he wanted to do it now, and he couldn't have done it in a better time because I needed the money really bad. So in conclusion to all of this, what I'm trying to say is trust the Lord. He knows what he's doing, even if you don't see things happening when you want to see them happen. It'll happen whenever he wants them to happen. Like the things that you want in life, he will help you out. He will take care of you. If you're not close to Jesus Christ, get close to him. Get to know him. You won't regret it. I mean, what can you lose? Nothing. You can gain a lot, though. Believe me. Because in my past, if I was to talk about my past, man, I've done so many bad things. And now, if you see me now, like the person that I am now, only God can.